Hi, hello, welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to do a video which was not expected. I didn't plan to do that first. I was planning to declutter my t-shirts and I have the intention to do that. It's just that something happened and I thought that it could interest you. So before I start, if you watched my last video about the Marcolis French book interview, the guy who wrote the book was interviewed by a French librarian or journalist, or I don't know exactly. I had some news since then. Some people told me that the book was much more accurate than the interview. So I don't understand why the author is accurate in the book and not accurate during the interview. It's strange to me, but know that the book is probably better than the interview, according to what I heard. I cannot tell because I don't have the book, so I cannot guarantee that it's true. So, you know that I already made several videos about decluttering makeup, and I'm not very good at decluttering makeup because I love makeup, and as long as a product works, I'm using it. But I also don't like having too much makeup because then I'm overwhelmed and I don't know what to choose. I don't very often buy makeup myself. I only buy when it's absolutely necessary, like for example, some mascara, because mascara don't last long, or lip balm, or when I finish my bronzer, because I use a lot of bronzer. When I finish my bronzers, I go and try to find a new bronzer. I love bronzers, so that is something that I use a lot. Oh, powder, to make the face more matte. I like to powder my nose. Powders are things that I use a lot. I also had some makeup. You know, when I was at Sephora, I don't remember the name of the subscription, Play by Sephora, I was receiving some bits and bobs of makeup. Some things were great, some other things were not great, and I stopped that because I had too much not great and it was not so interesting actually for me. I also was given some makeup, mostly by my mother. My mother gave me a lot of makeup because she used a lot of makeup and she liked changing and trying new things. So when she was done with something, she was giving them to me. The problem is that she was using much more makeup than I do. So sometimes it was a little overwhelming for me because it was things that I was not going to use. But in the same time, I couldn't really give that to someone else because it's difficult to give some makeup to someone else. I mean, unless it's your family. And I couldn't sell it, and it was difficult for me to throw it also because it was coming from my mother, and also because I don't like to waste products. She gave me a lot of lip glosses. She used a lot of lip glosses. I rarely buy lip glosses, even though I like them, but she gave me so many that I wanted to use up all the lip glosses that she gave me before going and buying a new one. So, for example, she gave me all these Chanels. These Chanels, I used up this one, so this one is done. I'm going to throw it. I used a lot of this one, still pretty full. And those ones, they are full, but it's too dark for me. Maybe this one, but I was not wearing them. I've had them since a very long time. I've had them at least 10 years. 10 years. I don't realize that because I have a very good memory for now, and I always remember when something is given to me, and for me it was yesterday. But I discovered a website were actually two websites, but one is better than the other. I will write the link for you in the description box, where with the batch number, you can find the date when it was made. You don't always have the batch number. However, I know exactly when it was given to me, and it was 10 years ago. 10 years ago. That is insane, because I remember for me it was yesterday. So for me it was there. I was like, okay, what I'm going to do with that? I don't know. I'm not using that. I like brown, but it's very wow. You can't miss it. It's very visible. I had that. I had other ones that she gave me. So I'm sorry that I'm not sorting in front of you. I sorted before the video. Why? Because I've been searching for the batch numbers every time I could, to have an idea of what I could get rid of and of what I could still use and keep. It's when the thing became complicated. I love this one. This one, I love it so much. It's Estée Lauder, Estée Lauder. And there is a batch number. I've been wearing it again and again and again, almost every day, but I did not know the batch number yet. I did not know how to search for the batch number yet. And I've been wearing it and wearing it and wearing it, but every day during almost 1 week, and I started having a pimple. I was breaking out here, and it was so painful, really painful. I could get rid of it with some green clay. You know, I did a cataplasm with green clay and water put there. And I'm not going to give you the details, but it was horrible and chiefly painful. And it could only come from that, because that was the one that I was wearing like crazy. But you understand that it belonged to someone else. Then I used it. Then you pull that out, you put it back inside with all the germ inside, and it stays like that. And you are supposed to use that, I don't know, it's not written how many months, but usually, I don't know, 6 months, 1 year at the best. And then you are supposed to throw it because it's not good anymore. I've had that. So this one's not 10 years, but 3 years, at least 3 years. And she used it before me. I think it must be something like, if I remember well, 5 years old. So you imagine how dirty it is inside. And I put that on my lips because I love the color. And then I had this terrible thing. And then I thought, okay, no. That is over. I must be very careful about what I put on my face, and especially what I put on my skin, what I put near my mouth, what I put near my eyes. So all these ones, Estée Lauder, same collection, same period, I have to throw them also. They don't look good. So this one is a little different, because these ones are, there is like a sponge tip there. This one is a little different. There is a brush and it's more oily. So it's not the same formulation. That's why it looks better probably. But it's the same period, and that is not good. It's too old to put on my mouth. So I have to throw them. Then I had these three Rochas ones. Love them. They are as old. They all have been used. They are not new. Same thing. Lovely. But I have to throw them. So then it's this Bourjois effet 3D. So it's a 3D effects. So this one, I finished it. I finished it a while ago. So I probably used it when it was still good. This one is very old and it's almost full, but it's too old. I have to throw them too. Makes me sick, but my health is more important than the product. So those ones, I had them when I opened my shop in 2010, at the beginning of 2010. So it's 11 years ago. I used some of them, not all of them. Same thing, I have to throw them. I'm sorry, I'm not here to depress you, but I cannot even give them away. These ones, this Canibo International. So this one, I almost finished it. And these ones are almost full. But same thing, these ones, they are maybe 4 or 5 years old. They are gorgeous. Those ones, look at the beauty of this one. The brand is T. Leclerc. That is French. Maybe I will keep only the end, this thing, because it's so beautiful, but I cannot keep the product because same thing, I've had it since 4 or 5 years. Arc-en-Ciel, it's a French brand that we don't have here. And this is Arc-en-Ciel too. So Arc-en-Ciel is a very cheap brand, but very good products. This one, I don't know the brand, it's a crayon. It's almost done. I used a lot, but it smells weird. It smells weird. So I don't want to put that near my mouth. And then I had that as backup because it was still in this box. And I thought, yeah, this one is brand new. Nobody used it. Actually, yes, she used it. Even if it was in the box, half of it is gone. And the other day I tried it and it burnt my lips. So it's Lancôme. I love this product. It's a Juicy Tubes Mood by Lancôme. I know that it still exists, not the same packaging, but it still exists. But same thing, I have it since 3-4 years. So I have to throw it. Also, the product that I bought, Revlon Hot Pink. It's shimmery. You can feel the shimmer on your lips, but it's okay. Sorry. I've had that since, I think, at least 7 years, and I was not using it lately, and it looks weird, so I'm going to throw that away. This one, I think that I had that in Paris already. Je Mets. Yes, Je Mets, it's a French brand, and it's a lipstick which looks weird. I finished this Revlon lip butter. The color was Lollipop. I love that. It's completely broken. And I'm going to throw that because it's finished. Oh, these ones, I love them, but they are completely ruined. Actually, I used a lot of that. But there are still some remaining. Yes, not a lot. I used a lot of it. And this one, no, I used it less. Actually, I should stop buying hot pink things because I don't wear them much. It was Crush Gun. I think it's Revlon. The brand was written on it. Very good. Was staying on the lips a very long time. Wet n Wild Mega Slicks. The color is strange and it was really bad. Really, really bad. So goodbye. Anyway, these three, I've had them since 7-8 years. We don't realize because time passes really quickly and we don't realize. This one, oh, at least 5 or 6 years I had that. It's a NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream. It's almost done. I almost finished it. I didn't love that. Usually I like NYX products, but this thing, I cannot say that I loved it. Also, that was a sample that I received from Sephora. It was samples. I used a lot the pink, the muted pink one, but the other ones not so much, and I didn't like so much the products. It started being a little old, so same thing, I'm going to throw that because I'm not going to use that, and I cannot give that to someone else. I have this, it's a very long time. My mother gave that to me at least 10 years ago. And Makeup Forever, it's like a different nude. It's a little like lip gloss. It's not really like lipstick. I really love that. And it opens like this and you have a mirror and you have a brush. I'm going to keep the brush because the brush is good. Yes, it doesn't smell good. I like the product Makeup Forever. Anyway, basically, this is all what I'm going to throw. It's a lot. It's a lot. It's at least 2 or 3 pounds of products. It's sad, but in the same time, it's such a relief because it makes some space in my vanity, and I felt guilty not using them. So now the guilt can go away. So then, as I was feeling really in the mood to get rid of stuff, I continued with some lipsticks. So I'm going to show you what I'm going to throw away. When I say throw away, it's really throw away. I cannot donate, I cannot sell. I will try only to sell the packaging because the packaging sells rather well. And if the packaging doesn't sell, I will throw that away. I do my best to avoid too much trash, but there are limits to what I can do. So I have 2 Chanel, they are from the 80s. They are really old. The color here is Rouge Magique. I didn't use it much, a little but not much. It was like a bluish red, it's not so much what I wear. And this is Rouge Corail that I used but not much either, Rouge Corail, because I have another one named Soleil de Minuit, Midnight Sun, that I loved and that I used a lot and that I'm keeping just as a collector. Of course, I'm not going to use it anymore. Then this one, French Geranium by Estée Lauder. Look at the packaging. Beautiful, but really geranium red. This one is Rouge Abstrait by Lancôme. Look at this one. Rouge Dior Ever by Dior, number 522. It's a rather dusty pink, but chiefly look at the packaging. Look at how beautiful that is. This one is also Chanel, but much thinner. Rose Absolue by Chanel, number 10. It's a pink, a pearly pink. Look at how thin it is. So this was by Revlon, but Revlon in France is considered as high-end. I was very surprised to see Revlon so cheap in the drugstores here, but in France it's considered as high-end. And look at that, beautiful, and it's like a brick, brownish red. Whiny, the name, nice. These 2 ones are by Agnès B. I bought that at the Club des Créateurs de Beauté. It's a kind of a subscription in France. And Agnès B was creating products for them. So this one is Terre de Feu. Same kind of, a little like the one that I have right now by Lisa Eldridge. And this one is Noisette. Oh, I wore that a lot. But it's not good anymore. And you have the B of Agnès B at the top. These products that I'm going to show you now, I bought them not a very long time ago here, but they are not good anymore. So this is Bird Bees. It's between a lip balm and a lipstick. I cannot say that I love that. And the color was a Brimming Berry. I think it still exists, but I don't think that I'm going to buy it again. This was by CoverGirl, the Smooth Chise Oxo. Tweet me the name. It's a lip balm red. You see, I almost finished it and I didn't like it. I cannot find the name of the brand. It was probably written on the packaging and it disappeared. It's a matte red and it was not a good product. And this one, I wore it a lot, but it suffered a lot. It's by Neutrogena sunscreen lip balm. I bought that maybe 3-4 years ago. I used it a lot. It was in my purse. With the sun, it became a little disgusting. No. No, 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 no. So, all this to the trash also. Not exactly to the trash. It's going to be sold or recycled. Or to the trash, more exactly. So then I started wondering about the foundations that my mom gave me. I don't wear a lot of foundations. I wear foundation only for my videos and if really I go to a party at night, then maybe I will wear some foundation. When I go out, sometimes I'm wearing some BB cream. Lately with the masks, I don't like so much putting some BB cream or anything, because with the mask, with the heat and the sweat and I wear some makeup on my eyes. I put some bronzer, yes, but on the skin, I hate foundations. I really don't like foundations. I think it's disgusting. But sometimes it's necessary. In my case, it's very often necessary because my skin is not what it used to be. I'm going to show you all what I'm going to throw away. And that must be thrown away because no way that anybody uses that. So first, that was mine. I bought that in Paris in 2009, I think. L'Oréal Poudre Minérale Couvrance Fond de Teint. It's a powder, it's some powder, but foundation. I used it, not completely, but I used it. It's a little dark for me, but when I'm tan here in summer, it's kind of okay. But did I like it? No. I didn't like it. And now it's too old, so it's going to go away. I don't even know if I'm going to keep the brush. The brush goes like this. Maybe I will keep the brush, but I must clean the brush because the brush is really dirty. Okay, then, new accident. I have that Le Blanc de Chanel Illuminating Base. It's a primer. Supposed to last 12 months. I have had that since my mother gave it to me, since 3 or 4 years. 3 years and a half, let's say. So I had a doubt because it's a very good product. The other day, and there is a pump, so it's a little more clean, let's say. We don't put our finger in it. I tried it on my hand here. It burnt my hand. So I was so glad that I didn't do that on my face because I cannot imagine what would have happened. It's going to go to the trash. I cannot even recycle the bottle because I cannot even open it. It's sealed. So it will have to go to the trash. But so much more space in my home also. The most difficult for me it was these two ones, Clinique. I wore them on my videos. Supposed to last 2 years. I've had them since 3 years and a half. I was breaking out with that. Yes, I can recycle the bottles. I mean, empty them, clean them, recycle the bottles. Maybe I will try to sell the bottles for people who are interested in using bottles by Clinique. Because the bottles, they are in glass, frosted glass. They are very beautiful. So I will try to do that. If it doesn't sell, it will go to the trash. But I try to avoid too much trash. I'm not going to sell them a high price, you know. I'm not going to make a living with that, for sure. Then there is this Shiseido one. It's the makeup dual balancing foundation, SPF 15. Same thing, it's too old. This one, it's a Sansai fluid finish Canebo. The color is soft beige. It's completely separating. No. And you know, here it's hot, so the things don't last long here. It's not hot all the time, but sometimes it's hot. Creamy beige by Canebo Cosmetics. So that is a container like that. It looks nice. When I look at it like that, it looks nice. But I know it's old and I don't feel comfortable putting that on my face. So here are two, it's the same thing. One is darker than the other one. Shiseido Stick Foundation SPF 15. I already tried this one. I look greasy. I look greasy with it. I don't like them. Same thing for this one. This one is really old. Shiseido Moisture Mystic Foundation. And it smells weird. Mm. But look at the packaging, how nice it is. This one is Makeup Forever. I got it through Sephora. I didn't like it so much. And now it's 4 years old, so no. So this is something, a brand that we don't have in the US and which doesn't exist anymore. The brand doesn't exist anymore. The name is The Tools. I try to find the website. I don't find it. And it's things like that. There is pink. This one is bleu-violet. blue, purple, rose light, bleu violet, rose light, abricot doré, golden apricot. My favorite one is this one. I wore that. You put that on the skin and it looks a little more bronzed. The color is sienna, sienne. The problem is that it's old. So even though I like the product, it's really nice, but I'm afraid on my skin to break out. So all this is going to be thrown away. I will try to recycle the bottles and the packaging. I will see if I can do that. But makeup doesn't last forever, unfortunately. So why am I telling you all this? I'm in my process of decluttering and I didn't plan to declutter my makeup. But the discovery of these two websites where I could see the dates when it was manufactured, and because what happened on my lips because of this lip gloss, it was like an awakening somehow. That's why I wanted to talk about it to you, so maybe you can check your own makeup and you are going to be surprised. Sometimes you buy a new product, so you think it's brand new because you just bought it. But sometimes the product has been manufactured like 1 year sooner, because they have they can keep the product on the shelf sometimes 1, 2, 3 years. But be aware that when you buy it, it's not automatically when it has been manufactured. I had a lot of surprises like that. So, of course, as long as it's not open, it doesn't get damaged. But as soon as you open it, it's the beginning of the end somehow. Just know that there is an expiration date. It's like if you were eating something which is expired. It's disgusting. You are going to be sick. I precise that my video is not sponsored, that I'm not paid by any brand, by anybody to do this video. I'm talking about what I like and what I'm going to throw away. It's only coming from me. I'm completely free. I'm not going to put you links, affiliate links, where I will make money from it. No, $0 from this video. It's really free service. I do it for the fun. Okay. If one day I'm paid for something, you will be the first ones to know. No brand paid me. No. Okay, so I have for lips, I just have this plus my Nivea that I put here because I have a small mirror. So when I'm at my desk, I have a mirror. I can see what I'm doing. And I have that because this plus this, it's so gorgeous. So the whole day I'm like at my desk. In my bathroom I have this, so I must tell you the story of this. These are lip stains by Sephora that I've had since, I don't know, my son, my older son bought that for me like 12 years ago, something like that. But I can still use them because there is some alcohol in it. It's just a stain. There is some alcohol in it, so it stays clean. I never had problem with that and I'm using them. This is a e.l.f. lip balm and honestly, I bought it for the packaging. I didn't use it much because it's a little dry. I don't like it so much. So I'm going to try to use it. If I don't, it will go away. This one, I used it a lot. It's almost finished. I must just finish it. Yeah, you see, I think that at that point, I keep it just for the packaging. The funny story is about these ones. So this one, I bought it myself. It's by Revlon. It's matte. It's a matte lip color. And the color is 610 HD Addiction Dependence. Weird name. And it smells like cake. So, I love it just for the smell. No, the color is really nice. Color is like strawberry, not strawberry, like raspberry, very raspberry. It's really nice. The problem is that when I put it, it goes everywhere. So I put it and I remove most of it with the Kleenex. and then it's okay. I like that. The other story is this one. The brand is Ciate. Yes, Ciate. The color is Diva. It's really red, red, really red. It's the second one here, really red. The color is gorgeous, but every time I put it on, I have some everywhere. On my forehead, on my eyes, on my hands, on my cat. I found some on my cat. So I tried, like for the other one, to remove most of it. Just keep the color. But even like that, I put some everywhere. So I'm going to try. It's not so old. These two ones, I can only use them at home because I would look ridiculous outside with that because I would have some everywhere. I precise that I'm not a makeup artist. I'm not giving you advice. I'm just telling you what is happening to me. Okay? And I don't plan to do videos about makeup in the future. It may happen again, but I mean, it's not the purpose of my channel. I don't plan to become a beauty guru. No, 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 no. So what is remaining for me is this that I bought myself not such a long time ago, maybe 5 years ago. No, I use it not much, just for my videos, basically. We can see, but I'm about halfway already. Is it good? No, I don't think so. It's a Revlon Nearly Naked makeup, color ivory. When you look at me closely at home, it's not great, but on the camera, it really looks nice, according to me. So I'm continuing to use it because it's what gives me the best result on the camera. And once it's done, I will probably buy something else because I cannot say that I love it. Otherwise, I use Maybelline Dream BB Fresh. I bought that recently. When I say recently, I think 4 or 5 months ago. So it's rather recent. It's the 110 light medium sheer tint. It's really sheer. It's not a foundation. That's all what I have now. And that's perfect. That's fine. I don't like that anyway. So why would I buy more? So now I must talk to you about something not exactly the same. Still about makeup, but it's a story. And I'm going to try to say it the nicest as possible and without giving names, because I don't want to put the shame on anybody. I'm not here to criticize people, I don't know how we say people. I'm here to talk in good about a product. And I precise that I'm not paid by this product, by this brand, by this person. Nobody asked me to do that, but I felt the need to do it because I thought that I would regret it if I was not saying it. And you do whatever you want with it. I'm not here to sell anything. I'm just here to tell you what I think, and that's it. 3 years ago, it was in 2018, maybe at the end of 2018, Emily Noel, so I'm giving you her name because I'm going to say only nice things about this woman. She has a channel, she's a beauty guru, we can say. She has a beauty channel. I followed her since, I think, 2008 or 2009, something like that. From her kind of beginning, it seemed. I remember that the first time I watched one of her videos, she was talking about the fact that she used to work at a radio or at a TV, a local radio or local TV, something like that, and that she was stopping because it was too early in the morning. She had to go to work at 3 a.m. or 4 a.m. or something like that. And that it started being difficult for her because she was married. I think she was married then, yes. And she didn't have kids yet. Now she has 3 kids. And I was following her since then. And I love this woman because she's the nicest woman I have ever seen. always positive, always nice. Even when she doesn't like a product, we have the feeling that she still liked the product. Even if she didn't like it, she says it so nicely that we feel like if she liked the product. And she's very good at makeup. And she has a skin tone which is kind of a little like mine. And she has a way to do her makeup, which is a little similar as I do mine. I'm not saying that I'm as good as her. No, no. I'm just saying that I understand what she's doing because I basically would do the same. I precise that I'm not a makeup artist. I'm not a beauty guru. I only do the makeup for myself. I know how to do the makeup for myself, except for a Halloween party in a shop where I did the makeup for about 60 kids. But it was for Halloween. It's not the same kind of makeup. But I did it about 60 kids in the day. I was very exhausted at the end, and that's basically it. I'm sorry. What I was saying, yes, I like watching makeup videos because I'm always curious about the products. It doesn't mean that I'm going to buy the products. It just means that I want to know what's new and how we can use that and what people think of this, of that. Actually, Emily Noel is the one who advised us to buy this, and I did, and I'm grateful to her for that, because that is really a good product. I have several products that she recommended and that I bought, but I try not to buy too much because otherwise it would become insane. One day, I think it's at the end of 2018, she released a palette, actually two palettes, The Needs and The Wants. It was a collaboration with Makeup Revolution. I know of Makeup Revolution, but I don't have any product by this brand. So I cannot say that I know this brand and that I like this brand or not. I don't know this brand. I know of it, but I don't really know it. I thought it was great because she really deserved to have her own product because she's so good at makeup. And I was surprised that it didn't happen before, because really, Emily Noel, she has been on YouTube since a very long time. So I think that she deserved more than anyone else to have her own product. And it could only be good because she always recommends really good products. And she's very picky with the product. She knows what she wants. She knows what color she likes. So I knew that whatever she would do, it would be good. Did I buy the palettes? No. I wanted to, and they are cheap, you know. The Needs is around $15, and The Wants, it's a big eyeshadow palette, it's around $20. You could find it at Ulta then, Ulta. Now you can find it at Ulta and Target. I didn't buy them. Why? Because I couldn't justify to buy them. As I said, I tried to have less, so I didn't want to bring more. And I'm not a big fan of palettes in general, but I was very happy for her. And I thought that maybe if later I need them, maybe I would buy them, or one or two, whatever. And then it was before the pandemic, yes. Another beauty guru who I was following too, since a little less time, but still I was following her. So I'm going to call her the beauty guru, because I don't want to give her name. First, because I don't want to put the shame on anybody. Second, because we are bullied as soon as we talk about that. So I don't want to have this problem. So this beauty guru, I won't give you her name. And if you ask me the name in the comments, I won't tell you. Don't be mad at me if I don't answer your question, if you are asking me the name, because I won't tell you. I don't want to be in trouble, and I don't want to put the shame on anybody. Anyway, this beauty guru that I was following also, I've been following her since maybe 2010. So a little later than Emily Noel, but still, since a very long time, at least 10 years, 11 years, something like that. The other one, the beauty guru, I was following her, not because of the product she was using, because I rarely bought products that she was recommending. It's just because her videos were funny. She was trying crazy products that I would never buy, but it was interesting to, or sometimes products which are so expensive that it's even ridiculous to buy them, but I was just curious. Or sometimes she was going to CVS or Walgreens on Mondays because it's coupons day and there are many rebates, and she was trying to pay the least as possible the product, and she was taking us with her in these drugstores to show us how she could have low prices for these products with the coupons, promotions and all that. And it was fun. It was entertaining. So I precise that when I watch these videos, I'm not like that watching. I'm usually working on Photoshop, and you don't need to have the usually when I'm on Photoshop, I can listen to something else in the same time. I'm able to do the both. So Emily Noel as this beauty guru, I was watching them while working on Photoshop. So it was entertaining and fun and pleasant. Everything was fine. But this beauty guru, who used to be really big, when I say big, she's not big. I mean, her channel was really big, a lot of subscribers. She made a review of the two palettes by Emily Noel. So first, I think that it's complicated to review the products of someone else on YouTube, because if you like them, it means that you are friend with the other woman, and can we trust your review? If you don't like them, it means that you are jealous or biased, not honest. So I always think that it's very complicated for beauty gurus in general to review products made by other people on YouTube because of that. But when she started her review, so she said it was a review, but it was not a review. It was a first impression, more exactly, because she didn't know the product at all. I could see on her face that she was not going to like them. And when she started, I was like, oh, we are going to have a problem here. I could see on her face. Before even starting, I could see on her face that it was going to be unpleasant. How could I know? It's because I've known her. I don't know her, but I've watched her on video since a very long time. So I know her expressions. And she made her the most surrealistic review I've ever seen. She, how to say that? She used not the right products at the right place. And she's very good at makeup. I'm very bad at makeup compared to her. She's very good. So there is no way that it's because she didn't know. She knew what she was doing. She used a matte dark brown on her lid, and she used her finger to put it on the lid, which is the most absurd thing to do. Everybody who uses makeup knows that you can't do that like that. Matte eyeshadows are matte, are powder. Your finger, it's oily. There is always some oil on your fingers. If you do that, of course it's going to be patchy. It's ridiculous. Why did she do that? And usually the brown color, we don't use it for the lid. We use it for the crease, or maybe to line the underneath, or maybe at the back of the eye, not on the lid. You could say, oh, but it was her way to do it. No, she never did that before. So why doing it with this palette? She was using the Wants palette. Why did she do that with this palette? Because that's my impression. That's my opinion. I had the feeling that she wanted to sabotage the palette. She barely tried the other one, the Nits palette. She barely used it. She said, oh, that's not for me. And she took another blush and she put the blush on. So what shocked me, it's not the fact that she didn't like the products. It's the way she did it. Also, she said, oh, Emily Noel should have used another brand to do her collaboration. She should have used Colourpop. Like if Emily Noel could choose who to work with. I imagine that if tomorrow someone, if Makeup Revolution comes and say, oh, Yael, you are going to do a makeup product with us, I'm not going to say, hello, Makeup Revolution. No, I prefer Colourpop. I'm going to say thank you. I don't know why they would do that because I'm not a beauty guru, but you see what I mean. You don't choose who you are going to work with in this situation. You have the opportunity to work with this person and you say thank you. Especially that Makeup Revolution has not a bad reputation. The problem is that this beauty guru, 1 year later, released her own palette, which was made in the same place where Colourpop does their makeup. So, what was that? The problem is not that she didn't like the palette, because you know, Emily Noel likes more what is matte, something that you can wear every day. Sometimes it's more elaborate, but she uses a lot of matte products. Not a lot of glitter and shiny things. I like matte, but I also like shiny things. I would say that I'm in between. So of course, the beauty guru who did this crazy review, she likes what is shiny. She likes when we look like a disco ball. So of course, the palettes by Emily Noel, it's not that, it's something else. She could have said, these products are nice, they work really well. It's not my cup of tea, but I imagine that some people can like that. That's nice. That's a good way to give an opinion. And I would have understood. The problem is that she didn't say that she didn't like them because it was not her cup of tea. She said that the products were bad, that they were patchy, that they were not working. So then, told you it was in 2018, I could have said something, I could have given my opinion then, but I didn't. Why? Because I didn't have the products, so I can only believe Emily Noel, the people that I know who have the palettes and who liked them, or different reviews that I watched on YouTube. But I didn't have the palette myself. Palettes, because there are two, myself, none of them. So I couldn't give my opinion, because I like to give my opinion when I'm sure, that when I tried myself the product. Lately, I was almost finishing my bronzers, my powder bronzers. I still have some, but I'm reaching the pan. So I start thinking, okay, I will need soon a new bronzer. And I thought, the Needs palette by Emily Noel, Makeup Revolution, it's called the Emily Edit. I will write the name in my description box. I will not give you links. You can go to Ulta, Target, or nowhere. You do whatever you want. Anyway, I'm not here to sell something. I'm just here to explain to you something. So I was talking about the Needs palette. The Needs palette is a palette where there is some eyeshadows, but there is also some bronzer, some blush, some highlighter, some powder. And you have all this for $15. I thought, okay, a bronzer will cost me at least $10 if I buy it in a drugstore. Why wouldn't I support Emily Noel? And I will have my bronzer and all the rest on the palette, and it will cost me $15. I mean, from a price point of view, it's more interesting. So I saw that it was sold at Target. I have a Target red card. I didn't even pay for the shipping, so with the tax, I think that I paid between $16 and $17. And here is what I got. So it comes like that in the box. This is Emily Noel here, and you have all the explanation at the back. Nice. I kept the box chiefly to show you. And then inside, so it's in plastic, a pink plastic, written in gold. It's really nice. then it's like that. So you have this film on the top and you have the names. See the big mirror, right? And all this. So here you have, I'm not here to sell you something. I'm here to explain to you something. I already said that and I say it again. Basically, you have here all the eyeshadows. So usually I start with this one that I put all over my lid, that piece. And then I put that, I put the face in the crease. And then above the crease as a transition color, I put Honesty. It's a very warm, dusty rose color. And then on the V, on the outer side of the eyes, usually use Hope. The white one, Love, I put it there. I like the color. I love the shimmer. I usually love the shimmer. But it's a little, it falls a little. So you must be careful with this one. I usually use it rather to line my eyes. I love the fact that she put some powder, Kindness, to make the under eye matter, because my mascara have a tendency to transfer there. So I use that on my lid and underneath. That's perfect. Perfect. Such a good idea. And then I have here Courage, which is my bronzer. Blush named Joy, which is beautiful. I have nothing like that in my collection. Even this color, Honesty, the eyeshadow, I have no eyeshadow like that. So I was very happy to have something different from what I usually have. And the highlighter is Gratitude, and I really love that. So, okay, it's not a highlighter like a disco ball like this beauty guru likes usually. It's more discreet, but for my videos, I have it right now. I put it here. Put it here. Sometimes I put it here. That is a brush for watercolor. I cleaned it before, of course. I use it for my highlighters. It works really well, and I had that for my paintings. It works perfectly. So I only use it for my makeup now, of course. This is an amazing palette. I tried it. It's not good. It's excellent. It's amazing. I made all my makeup with it today. And it's not the first time that I tried it. I wore it maybe 6-7 times already, and I bought it not a long time ago, maybe 1 month ago. It's not good. It's excellent. So my question, I don't know how we say, is why? Why this beauty guru said that it was not working? I'm very bad at makeup. I'm not a beauty guru. If I can use it, she can too. I'm not a specialist. I'm not a professional. I'm not a makeup artist like Lisa Eldridge. Okay, this beauty guru is maybe not a makeup artist. He's just a beauty guru. But she's very good at, as Emily Noel, she's very good at makeup. If I can use it without having some patchiness, without having any problem, she can do it. So why sabotaging such a great product? $15 for all this. I'm not here to sell you something. You do whatever you want. When a product is released, it's not only the person who created it or the brand who created it. It's also the people who are working in the manufacturing to make it. Imagine if it's sabotage like that for no reason. There is probably a reason, but I don't know what. For me, it's ridiculous reason. It's not bad only for Emily Noel, not only for Makeup Revolution, but for all the people who are working on that. And their work depends on the success of the product. I was honestly horrified. Horrified because I've been following this beauty guru since about 2010. I always thought that this person was honest and was saying really what she was thinking. Now I have doubts. Because if she had said the product works well, colors are great, But it's not my cup of tea, it's not the kind of thing that I would put on my face, then okay, everyone is entitled to have one's own taste. I get that. I was shocked then. I watched that video and I was like, what happened? What is going on? What's the problem? And now that I tried the product, I know, I said that I won't buy some makeup anymore, but I needed a bronzer. That is the occasion to buy the palette. I don't regret to have bought this palette, because if I had listened to this other beauty guru, I wouldn't have bought it and it would have been a pity. It has been released in 2018 and it's still sold now. And there are a lot of reviews. I'm not going to do the makeup in front of you because I'm not a beauty guru. I don't have the right lighting. I don't have the right camera. I cannot do that in front of the camera. I suck at makeup, really. It's a miracle what I managed to do. But you can watch thousands of reviews where people are saying, that's good. That's really good. So why? Why sabotaging a product like that? I think we have enough bad products. We don't need to sabotage the ones which are really good. And you know, it's not because I don't know the high-end products. I know the high-end products. For example, something that I love by Dior. It's not brand new. It's a product which exists since a while. And I'm sorry, it's a little damaged, but this, there is some shimmer here. The name is Bronzy Look. Number 695. It's a duo and I love this product, but I can love this and I can love this. Not the same. One day I want some shimmer, I'm going to use that. One day I want some matte, I'm going to use that. That is perfect. I go to my son's place during a weekend. I take that. I have everything I need here, except for my mascara and maybe a lip product. But I mean, I have most of what I need here. I bought that. I recommend that. Les Beiges by Chanel. It's a creamy bronzer. I wanted to buy that since a very, very long time, since 2 years. And I decided to spend my money. It's very expensive. But wow, I love that. I can love that. And I can love that. It's creamy, it's powder, two different products. I usually use the both together. I am able to appreciate very expensive blush. For example, this one. The name is L'Orchidée by Sisley. They say blush, highlighter blush with white lily. For me, it looks more like between blush and bronzer. I love it. Can love that. And I can love that. For the highlighter, I'm able to love that. That is by Dior. Dior Skin Nude Hair Luminizer. Wow. It's unbelievable. I love it. 001. When I wear it, I look like a disco ball. I know. It doesn't matter, for example, if I have to go outside, well, not so much, but if I go to a fancy place or even for myself sometimes, I put that on. I love that, but I'm able to love a highlighter like this. It's much more. I don't know if you are going to see the difference because I have light coming from there, but it's not what I call a discreet highlighter. No, it's in your face, but I can love that. And I can love that. And this is expensive. And this is cheaper. This is more in your face. This is more discreet. I can love both. And this one, when I put it on my face, and when I go at night to remove the makeup, it's still there. It didn't move, especially on the eyes. It's incredible. Because the face, I touch my face, so of course I damage my makeup. But the eyes, it's incredible how good it is. It stays in place, it doesn't move. It's incredible, the quality is incredible. So it's not good, it's excellent. And I'm able to like that too. $3 by e.l.f. I have the rose water. As long as it works, it's good. And in the meantime, I didn't know that, but I heard that later. Because when this story happened, I was shocked. And then something happened in my work, or I don't remember exactly, and I was distracted and I didn't follow the story, but I was still in shock about that. And later I discovered that another beauty guru, I'm going to call her the third beauty guru, her name, I'm going to call her the sarcastic one. So the sarcastic one made a video to talk good about this product. And when I saw this, when I watched this video later, when I discovered that it was released, maybe I watched it, I don't know, maybe 1 year after it was released. And I watched that video and I thought, oh, thank you. Why am I telling you all this? It's because I think that when we do videos on YouTube or when we put anything on internet in general, we must be very careful about what we are saying or what we are doing, because we have a responsibility towards the people who are watching us. We must be very careful about what we are saying and what we are doing. And you know, after that, there were other problems on this channel of this beauty guru, not the sarcastic one, the reviewer one. There were other problems which confirmed what I was feeling. And I don't follow her anymore. I don't know what was the deal in that. I don't know what was the problem. I don't know why she did that. I don't know. I would like to know, but I don't know. So I can only suppose, and all this is my opinion. It's how I lived it. As a viewer, because in this situation I was the viewer, I need to trust the person I'm watching, even if it's just to listen to a video while I'm working on Photoshop. Because I don't want my brain to be full of things which are false. When I have the feeling that someone is saying stupid things on a video, I stop watching. In that case, it was not stupid. It was very elaborate. It was intentional. Why? When I feel that I'm lied to, I don't like it. And I go away. Here, the problem has never been solved. There was no solution. Fortunately, enough people on YouTube, creators, defended this palette. These palettes. I cannot tell you for the other one. The name of the other one is The Wants. I couldn't justify to buy it because it's a lot of eyeshadows. And I don't use enough eyeshadows to justify this purchase. And in general, I cannot say that I love palettes. I prefer little things like that, two or three colors, or even four quads like that, four colors, because it's very small. And for me, it's easy. But this palette is not very big. So it's convenient and there is everything on it. So I could justify that. I cannot justify the bigger one with I don't know how many eyeshadows for $20. I cannot tell you how it works because I didn't use them. But if it's the same formulation as on this one, it's excellent. Excellent. Actually, my throat hurts so much I talked. I'm not used to talk. I spend a lot of time alone, not talking except to my cat. He answers sometimes. I'm going to stop here because I have some work to do. And next time I will declutter my t-shirts, and that is going to be difficult because I don't know what I have with my t-shirts, but I cannot even say that I love them. It's just that I use them a lot and it's hard for me to get rid of t-shirts. I don't know why. I must think about it. I think it's not going to be as satisfying as what I did with all the makeup that I'm going to throw now. Anyway, I'm going to stop here. Don't forget to like this video if you do, to subscribe if you want to, and click on the bell to be notified when I release a video. And comment if you have any questions. And I assure you that this is not an advertising for Emily Noel. It's just that I wanted to say how much I love this palette. I wanted to say it because I thought if tomorrow I die, I would have regretted not to say it. So now I've said it and I'm good to go. If one day I buy the other palette, I don't think so, but if I do, I will let you know and I will tell you what I think about them, of these eyeshadows. Even though I'm not a makeup artist, I'm not a beauty guru, I'm just a woman who makes her own makeup. Not every day, but every 2 or 3 days. Oh, I usually put something on my face every day. Okay, even if it's just a lip balm, I usually do something on my face every day. And there is a lot of work, unfortunately, now. Okay, I see you soon. Bye.